Darren, after falling behind, your team showed real character to come back and get a point today.
Very good performance as far as the second half. We talked about our preparation in the build-up to this game, having played Tuesday. They've got a new manager. They didn't play Tuesday, so it's a very difficult place to come, Hartlepool, as far as mentally and physically. And what you could see there is that the players kept going from start to finish. And I felt towards the end we looked fitter than them, which is a good sign.
You entered the game really well. Let's talk about how the equaliser came about. And Francois Zocco, he can sometimes drift in and out of games. When he does what he did to that defender there to win the penalty, he's virtually unplayable.
Yeah, he is, and that's what Francois can do. He can have spells, like any forwards could have spells, not being in the game. I thought that was the same as Tom Eaves at Blackpool. We had large spells where the forwards didn't really have great possession, then all of a sudden he flicks it up and it's a crossbar, and that's why they've got that special talent. And Francois played a massive contribution this year to gain us goals and momentum.
I'm going to ask you about the penalty, because I know Kevin Dawson is your penalty taker. He's suspended today. Was it pre-arranged that Matty Dolan would take that today?
Well, Matty's taken him before Dawson, so being up against his old club as well, I thought it was a good opportunity for Matty, and it just shows that he can handle that pressure. So now we're really pleased that when you look at the other results, and you know, even though we want to be able to pick up 3 points, I thought we were the better team. I thought we deserved the 3 points, certainly in the second half. And unfortunately that didn't happen, but you put all these away performances together, these points, and you pick up 3 points at home, then you know, we could be in a better place.
Of course, you came close to a winner, Matty Dolan's free kick. Does he practice them in training all the time? Because his technique on those seems excellent.
Yeah, when he steps up to take it, you know there's going to be problems as far as the keeper's concerned. And it was the same against Crewe, and I thought that could have been that little bit of magical moment where that flies in the net. But Owen Jones makes his league debut today, another one that we've given opportunity to. I thought Jean played very well. He's not played 90 minutes regular, so he came into our system. I thought he was very, very effective. Omar comes on up top, who's got a major role to play. And I thought Ben Whitfield and certainly Matt Butcher, for being young players to come away to Hartlepool and grind out a result, was fantastic considering what we went through on Tuesday.
36 points now. You're a long way further forward than where you were at this time last season, and you can almost start to throw the shackles off and just go for the wins to get you up that table now. Because if you look below you, the gap down to the bottom two is a long way away.
We're never looking to throw the shackles off. No way. It's not my style. No chance. So I don't want the players to hear that, because this group of players are hungry, and they keep driving me every day. And I said today, we went over and shook the supporters' hands. I thought it was a nice touch for the club to pay for their travel. And, you know, I feel we're getting that unity together again. And I feel next year we can build again, even though we want to reach the dizzy heights of the playoffs straight away. I still think it's in sight, but we've got to pick up one or two wins very, very soon to keep in touch and distance. And the players make me feel proud to come and work every day. And now we've got a big game on Tuesday. So all we can think about now, as soon as I finish this, is the preparation, and look forward to a great game, quarterfinals in the Chequered Trade.
I was going to say that. I mean, in the league, you're trying to keep it alive and get the wins that keep the playoffs realistic ambition, and of course quarter-final of a cup tie, so an exciting end to the season building.
I just want the supporters to arrive with the last, what is it, 9 or 8 home games that we've got, and there's a little bit of excitement. I still think it's there. I still think if the players pick up, we've got Leighton Orient next, which will be a good game for us, and a game that we're looking to win like we do every game. But I think when we look at overall, and it was difficult for me to explain last time with the Wickham, Blackpool, Exeter, Portsmouth being so close, that win against Plymouth just shows that you can achieve any result, and we'll be looking to do that at home against Leighton Orient.
Just finally, you lost Alex Lacey today to an injury. Do you know yet what he's done?
We don't know the extent. Obviously he's sore. It's difficult to bend, but he's a quick healer.
It's his knee, is it?
Yeah, it's his knee. He's a quick healer, so... And he's frustrated in there, but I said, keep your head up, because you never know. He could make a quick recovery, and we'll be doing our best to make sure all these players get the right preparation and going into this game on Tuesday.